Hello and welcome again to the Hobo and His Girlfriend Wrestling Show here on YouTube. There goes my cat. My name, however, is Hobo Tom. My girlfriend, I think, is going to be stopping by later. I think, well, after I put this video up. I'd like to thank everyone for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Again, just a couple of programming notes. On Sunday night, probably Monday morning, I'll have my review of Women's Evolution. And I have my little note card thing. I think they changed the match. She changed one of them. Again, I did my predictions with my girlfriend. And I think at the time they didn't have this match, but I want to say it's going to be Banks, Bailey, and Natalya, the Riot Squad. This is going to be such a long pay-per-view to watch. I'll say the faces go over. The Riot Squad's going to need another loss. Hopefully it's not Ruby Riot. Who's the tall? Yeah, Ruby Riot won. So therefore, yeah, my official predictions for WWE Evolution. And if you can read that, power to you. But let's not talk about that. Let's talk about some Lucha Underground. I know every once this season they only have one match that takes the entire night. I think last year it was a 30 minutes of Slamtown match where, well, it was really just an Iron Man match where the person with the most pinfalls over the course of half an hour, I think, wins. And of course, with the TV time intros and everything, that kind of sets up. And for about one whole TV show, because it's about 46 minutes long, they always have an intro, and they always have some kind of closing vignette. And then you have wrestler's intro. So yeah, it's about half an hour. So this was one of those, and this was the Gift of the Gods kind of Aztec warfare match, where they actually do explain the rules, which are pretty good. To begin the show, though, and please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Oh, the other programming note, on the 31st, on Wednesday, again, Monday will typically be Raw. Tuesday is going to be, well, the Yogs. SmackDown and Mixed Match Challenge. And to kind of celebrate Halloween a little bit, going to have, of course, some wrestling matches. We're going to have the most evil male wrestler. That's going to include Kane, The Undertaker, Bray Wyatt, of course, Evil Tom. I don't think there's any titles on the line, though. There's going to be the Good versus Evil Championship, the Good versus Evil match, where you have Gigi Heather and Princess Ikochi versus Mistress Heather, some other dastardly woman. To figure that out yet. Yeah, and if you want to, you can just send a comment and say who I can pair up with Mistress Heather. So to determine the good versus evil match. And then we have some backstage revenge. And you're going to have the Cuba Connection. I have to figure out if I'm going to do it individually or as a team. To figure that out a little bit. And versus the Lucha Dragons, because the Lucha Dragons stole their Lucha tag team belts. They won in a tornado tag team match, which was actually amazingly short. I don't think they're going to... Oh, wait! And because John Cena said he won't be there for a little Evolution because he's still single, and he's probably not going to Crown Jewel, he might see someone challenge for the Under the Bridge Championship. And I think that's going to be it. I don't think there's going to be a challenger. Well, again, Gigi Heather holds the bestest girlfriend ever belt. Crazy Liam has the always underweight belt. And those two, and that the always underweight belt's not on the line this time. I'll save that for, wow, my 100-hour mark. And that'll be a special show. But again, let's get back to Lucha Underground. Lucha Underground, again, once the season, they do have the one night, full night match. Again, they had kind of a little bit of a preview. Again, it's really fun. They have kind of the War is Hell match highlights from Dante Fox and Killshot. A little bit of the Gauntlet of Power. And a little thing about Jake Strong. And then today's mystery band was LDOT Goldust. I have no idea who they are. It just looks like Goldust painted himself a skull. But let's go to the action, because there's only one match today, and I'm not going to kind of go over it point by point, but I'll kind of show you like the real highlights of it. Yeah, and it says 7 to survive, so the first thing they do is they actually explain the rules.